You're talking Jersey. Taking your calls, 1-800-283-101.5. Talking about Atlantic City. I'm going to get to all your calls, and I know a lot of people are hanging on to. Talk about Atlantic City. I wanted to bring someone in. Tony Catanoso. Tony, did I pronounce that right?
Perfect.
That's pretty good, right?
Very good.
So you are the owner and the president of the Steel Pier.
Yes.
So just talking about family-friendly fun in Atlantic City, you got it.
We got it. There's plenty of it here.
So I know I want to talk to you about this whole political debacle that's going on with Atlantic City. But first, I got to ask you, I understand that you got your start because Donald Trump came in, gave you a lease and a deadline, and said, go do it, and you got 30 days to get it done.
Yeah, we had 30 days. We signed the lease in April, late April, we had to get it open by Memorial Day. So
yeah.
We had about 30 days to put the park together. So you've been here, we're entering our 26th
season. Why did you go to Trump?
Well, he owned the property, and he was operating a shuttle service out there, or this helicopter that they closed up, and we had an idea that we could put a park back out there. Because we knew the old Steel Pier was very successful. There was a need for a family entertainment here. So we met a guy, knew a guy, and got to a guy, and we finally got to Trump.
The guy who knew the guy.
That's it.
And Trump helped you make it happen.
Yeah.
How about that? That's a great story. And you've been open 20 years.
26 years.
26 years, no kidding.
We bought it 5 years ago.
So let me ask you, earlier, you took some issue. I had said that you know, when you look at what the politicians are talking about, you would think that Atlantic City is completely falling apart in disrepair and going to sink into the Atlantic Ocean. You took some issue with that. Tell me what's
the perception. That's the perception that's being painted by the political battle that's going on between Atlantic City and Trenton. There's $700 million in investment going on right now in Atlantic City. There's been $10 billion in the last 15 years in Atlantic City in investment. But right now, people talk about there's a lack of family entertainment in Atlantic City. That's people that aren't here and not seeing it. I can name a dozen places right now off of family entertainment. You've got Ripley's, you've got the Pier at Caesars, you've got Steel Pier. We made a $30 million investment in the last 5 years. We're making another $14 million investment in what's going to be the third largest observation unit in the United States. You've got Gardner's Basin. It goes on and on, the walk.
So as a business owner in Atlantic City, obviously you've got a vested interest. And my question is, the governor talked about the casinos in North Jersey, and specifically saying that if the bill doesn't pass the assembly, and Vinny Prieto is not going to even put up for a vote, so none of them know what happens, that he's going to actively oppose gambling in North Jersey. Now, I applauded him for that, because I think they should have been doing that without this. It doesn't make sense to me. What do you expect is going to happen, and what would be the harm in casinos in North Jersey to Atlantic City?
Well, they can make all these political promises they want about sending $200 million down to Atlantic City. Casinos open in North Jersey, we'll never see the $200 million. And if we did see the $200 million, are they going to divvy that up between 15,000 people that lose their jobs down here? What good is it going to do to them? It's going to be devastating to the economy down here. And you're right, if there's a problem here, invest a little more money here and fix that. But it's not a panacea for North Jersey. And the last six polls done by Fairleigh Dickinson show that the people in North Jersey don't want it. So, I mean, there's no mandate up there for casinos in North Jersey.
What about the mayor? I'm going to have Mayor Guardian on after the 8:30 news. And, you know, he has been very aggressive. I mean, he's dropped some big terms. I'm going to ask him about it. You know, it's a fascist takeover talking about. What's your opinion? I mean, I don't know if you support the mayor or not, but what's your opinion in, A, how the mayor's handling this crisis? Because it is a financial crisis on the government end for sure. You know, they've got debt. You've got some casinos now saying they're not going to pay the real estate taxes. There's a problem.
There's a problem, and you know the financial problem will get solved. But the estate takeover or bankruptcy not going to affect business in Atlantic City. It's not going to affect how we operate. We're here, we're operating, people are investing. That's going to get worked out. That's got to get worked out. But you know, the perception and the negative PR is what's killing us. But if you come to Atlantic City, everybody's open for business. Everybody's doing business, and there's plenty to do here. People talk about what do we have here for everybody? Well, we've got that piece of work, and as long as you have that, I mean, you've got something to build on. But we're already built, we're just continuing to build.
Can't make any more shoreline, right?
No,
we got it here.
Any more beaches.
All right, Tony Catanoso, owner of the Steel Pier, I really appreciate your time on New Jersey 101.5.
Thanks,
Inspector. Thank you. It was good to meet you, Tony. Thank you. All right, so let me get back to your calls, but you heard it from Tony. I mean, there is a lot of family activity here. There is a huge perception problem in this city. Michael and Clinton, you're on New Jersey, 101.5. Good morning.